Axiom could have a free flying station as early as 2028. NASA and Axiom are revising the assembly plan for the Axiom space station. Initially, they intended to connect the habitation module to the ISS, followed by three more modules, which would later detach to form a free flying station. To understand the new plan, it's crucial to first consider the context and the challenges currently faced by both NASA and Axiom Space. You'll see how this new strategy addresses these issues. First, let's look at NASA's problems. NASA is aware that the ISS needs to be deorbited by the end of the decade, probably in 2030. One worry is that Russia has only committed to 2028, and the station can't be operated by NASA alone. NASA has contracted SpaceX to provide a decommissioning vehicle that will, at the end of the ISS life, fire its thrusters and send the ISS into the Earth's atmosphere, where it will burn up. Another pressing issue is a persistent leak in the Russian section of the ISS, which began in 2019. Despite attempts to repair it, the leak persists, with 2024 seeing its highest air loss at 1.7 kilos of air per day. NASA is concerned about the structural integrity of the affected areas, fearing a catastrophic failure. There's a disagreement with Roscosmos, the Russian space agency, about how serious the leak is. Roscosmos believes it's manageable. Currently, the leak is controlled by isolating the affected area when not in use. Due to the potential for sudden failure, NASA wants the decommissioning vehicle ready on station to deorbit the ISS if necessary. Port conflicts also pose a problem. The Axiom module, originally scheduled to be attached to the ISS, uses the same port as the decommissioning vehicle. This is manageable, but not ideal. In the non-ideal scenarios where the leak grows or Russia abandons the station in 2028, the ISS might need to be deorbited earlier than planned. Deconflicting the ports would give NASA more operational flexibility, allowing both Axiom modules and the decommissioning vehicle to be attached simultaneously. Additionally, NASA has accumulated valuable equipment on the ISS over the years that it would like to save. Transferring this equipment to the Axiom module before it detaches would be ideal, but the habitation module has limited payload capacity. Let's now look at the challenges faced by Axiom Space. Axiom's primary issue boils down to one word: money. Building a space station is an expensive undertaking, and the sooner Axiom can start generating revenue from visitors to its station, the better. Originally, that wasn't expected to happen until the end of the decade, possibly 2030. Speeding up this timeline would not only ease Axiom's financial strain, but also kickstart the era of commercial space stations earlier. We'll examine in more detail Axiom's financial challenges later. Now let's explore the proposed solution that benefits both Axiom and NASA. New assembly sequence. At NASA's request, Axiom Space has decided to change its space station assembly plan. Instead of starting with the Axiom habitation module, they will now attach a new module, the Payload, Power and Thermal Module, or PPTM. Let's refer to it as the Payload Module for simplicity. Here's how the new schedule for the Payload Module unfolds. The primary structure of the Payload Module is being constructed by Thales Alenia Space in Turin, Italy, using existing structural components for efficiency. By the third quarter of 2025, this structure will move to Houston for further integration of internal systems at Axiom Space's facilities. In 2027, the payload module will be launched and docked with ISS. Come 2028, it will detach from the ISS to become a free-flying station. Axiom will then proceed to expand this station by adding more modules. First, the habitation module HAB1, followed by an airlock, another habitation module called HAB2, and finally, the research and manufacturing facility. NASA has been extremely collaborative and supportive of the new plan as it addresses its deorbit operational concerns and preserves critical capabilities currently utilized on the International Space Station. This revised approach not only aligns with the US objectives, but also delivers immediate value for our customers and investors. NASA is actively supporting the design and development of various commercial space stations, including Axiom Station, through both funded and unfunded agreements. After this design and development phase, NASA plans to purchase services for one or more of these companies. Next, we do need to talk about recent news concerning the financial viability of Axiom Space. Axiom's financial problems. In September 2024, Forbes published an article stating that Axiom Space was struggling to pay its bills, which raised concerns at NASA. Axiom is crucial for the Artemis missions because it's developing the spacesuits needed for lunar exploration. Currently, Axiom is the only company contracted by NASA to provide these spacesuits, making any issues at Axiom potentially disruptive to the Artemis program, since the spacesuit development is on a critical path. Axiom has 450 employees working on the station and close to 300 working on suits. In the Forbes article, they say, "The lack of fresh capital has exacerbated long-standing financial challenges that have grown alongside Axiom's payroll, which earlier this year was nearly 1,000 employees." Sources familiar with the company's operations told Forbes that co-founder and CEO Michael Soffredini, who spent 30 years at NASA, ran Axiom like a big government program instead of the resource-constrained startup it really was. His mandate to staff up to 800 workers by the end of 2022 led to mass hiring so detached from product development needs that new engineers often found themselves with nothing to do, these people said. To transport NASA astronauts to their commercial station, Axiom must secure a CLD-2 award, which stands for the second phase of the Commercial LEO Destinations program. This competition is expected to be intense, with NASA likely to award the contract to just one company. The initial phase of the CLD program took place in 2021, where companies like Axiom, Blue Origin, Vast Space, Sierra Space, SpaceX, and Voyager, with its Starlab project, received awards. The outcome of the CLD-2 award will likely determine the future viability of these commercial space station ventures. Currently, there isn't sufficient demand from private astronauts to sustain these stations independently. NASA is expected to serve as the primary tenant for the foreseeable future, underscoring the importance of securing this award for companies like Axiom. We will keep reporting on Axiom Space and other companies vying for commercial space station projects. It will be interesting to observe how the new NASA administrator's changes impact these programs. We'll continue to bring you updates on all the space startups from the US, Europe, and around the globe. Be sure to like and subscribe so you'll see our upcoming videos. We make videos every week covering the space industry, with an emphasis on the smaller space startups that aren't covered so well on other channels. See you soon!